So, good morning students, welcome to my channel. Today I gave to you a super trick from the integration. Okay, let us see this type of problems. So, which is from JEE 2017, you got this type of model. So, IN, integration of tan rise to the power of nx. And if I4 plus I6 is A tan power 5x plus BX power 5 plus C, then what are the values for A and B? Okay, same model, here the same problem, boundaries are given 0 to pi by 4, then what is I8 plus I10? And here also same model problem, limit n tends to infinity, n of IN plus IN plus 2. Okay, and I think the students, some of you students, I think you follow this method, both sides integrating, right, and comparing the quotients. That is also one more easy method I am going to explain. Let us see what it is. Okay. Yes, within 10 seconds you will get the problem. Okay. Yes, I think all of you know this one, the reduction formula for tan power nx dx. In equals to tan power nx dx, which is tan rise to the power of n minus 1 of x by n minus 1 minus n minus 2. Yes, I think you know all of you. Yes, from this one, just substitute n equals to n plus 2. Replace n by n plus 2. Now, this one, in plus 2 is tan power n plus 1 of x by n plus 1 minus in. Right? Then, I concluded that in plus 2 is tan rise to the power of n plus 1 of x by n plus 1. This is the shortcut what I am going to use. So, within 10 seconds you will get this problem. Yes, let us see. In plus in plus 2, all of you please see this one. In plus in plus 2, middle term n plus 1 is missed. Yes, now this value is tan rise to the power of which term is missed? N plus 1. N plus 1 of x by n plus 1 plus c. That's it. Yes, the same formula I am going to apply in this one. In is integration rise to the power tan rise to the power of nx. I4 plus I6. The 5 is missed. Actually, this value is tan rise to the power of 5x by 5 plus c. That's it. Now, actually what they have given? This is the value they have given. So, tan power 5x quotient is a. Here, tan power rise to the 5x quotient is 1 by 5. Right? So, my a value is 1 by 5. And b is the coefficient of x power 5. Here there is no term of x power 5. So its value is 0. That's it. Yes. And for the same one, boundaries are given 0 to pi by 4. What is this value? Yes, come on, please apply the boundaries for this value. Boundaries. So integration of 0 to pi by 4 tan rise to the power of nx dx. Okay. Now this is and when the value in plus in plus 2 is tan rise to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. Applying the boundaries for 0 to pi by 4, you will get that 1 by n plus 1. Very simple. Okay, now you will get the problem. In plus 2 is 1 by n plus 1 when the boundaries are 0 to pi by 4. Okay, now what is the value? I8 plus I10 is, which is missed? 9th term is missed. That is 1 by 8 plus 1. Okay, 1 by 9. That's it. And here, direct formula, this is limit n tends to infinity n of what is in plus 2 when the boundaries are 0 to pi by 4, which is 1 by n plus 1. Yes, I think you know this method. So, limit n tends to infinity n by n plus 1. Okay, so both the numerator and denominator having the same degree, power 1. Okay, I think you know this method. When limit n tends to infinite, here we have three cases. Of those, one of the case, degree of the numerator and the denominator is the same, then we will get the value is its coefficients from the numerator and the denominator, which value is 1. Okay, yes, this is the method. Let us see how it is very simple. Have a look. Come on, make it out. Yes, yes, students. Come to the next problem, which is in the same model. In is integration tan rise to the power of nx nx dx, then I naught plus 2 times of I2 plus I4. Yes, and one more problem. In is integration tan rise to the power of nx, then I naught I1 plus 2 times of I2, I3, I4, I8 plus I9 plus I10. What is this value? Yes, come on. Applying the same rule. Yes, let us see. So integration tan power nx dx is in plus in plus 2 is tan for n plus 1 by n plus 1 comma. So can I write like this? This one I naught plus I2 plus I2 plus I4. Can I write like this? That's all. I naught plus I2. Y1 is missing. That value is tan rise to the power of 1x by 1 plus, and this is I2 plus I4. 3 is missing, which is tan rise to the power of 3x by 3 plus C. Very simple. Yes, coming to the same model. Here, let us see. We are going to write as a base. So, how? What is the base? In plus In plus 2. Okay. Then its value is tan rise to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So like this also here I am going to arranging. This one is I naught plus I2. Am I right? I naught plus I2. And this one is I1 plus I3. And let us 2 times of I2, yes, 2 times of I3, 2 times of I4, 2 times of I5, yes, come on. Can you say this one? I0 plus I2, yes, 1 is missing, which is tan rise to the power of 1x by 1. This is I1 plus I3 is 2 is missing, tan rise to the power of 2 by 2, tan rise to the power of 3 by 3, tan rise to the power of 4 by 4. Right, Anand? Like this, you will get the problem. Okay, yes, come on, students, come on, make a note. That is a very simple shortcut, very important model. Okay, yes, come on, make a note. Yes, so coming to the next problem, students, next model. Integration 3 to 7, 1 by x minus 3 into 7 minus x dx. Integration minus 1 to 2, 1 by root of x minus of minus 1, x plus 1 into 2 minus x. Same model problem. Okay, I think now we got this model. Okay, yes, all the problems are in the form of integration of a to b. The first one is integration of a to b, 1 by square root of x minus a into b minus x dx. Okay, and coming to this problem, integration of a to b, it is root of x minus a into b minus x dx. And coming to this problem, integration of a to b, square root of b minus x by x minus a dx, or integration of a to b, square root of x minus a by b minus x dx. For all these type of problems, we have a tradition rule. Can you get that? What is the tradition rule? Substitution method. By taking x is equals to a cos square theta plus b sin square theta. Have you got the points, all of you? Yes. By proceeding in that method, it will take the time. Nearly it takes 2 to 3 minutes. Of course, maximum 5 minutes it will take that one. Okay, yes. So without using that, we are going to use that shortcut. Of course, that shortcut also will, by using the traditional method, we got this value. Okay, yes, integration of a to b, 1 by root of x minus a into b minus x dx. This value is 5. Okay, so this value is 5. And this is 5 by 8 of b minus a whole square. Integration of a to b, root of x minus a into b minus x dx, which is 5 by 8 of b minus a whole square. And this type of modulus, integration of a to b, root of b minus x by x minus a dx, or integration of a to b, root of x minus a by b minus x dx, which is pi by 2 of b minus a. Okay, so this is the form what we are going to use that shortcut. Okay, coming to this one, which value is 5? This value is 5, and this is pi by 8 of, right, pi by 8 of b minus a whole square, 2 minus of minus 1, 3 square, which is 9, thus 8. And coming to this one, yes, I think it is also in the form of integration of a to b, square root of x minus a into b minus x, 6 minus x dx. Yes, and again, 5 by 8 of b minus a, 6 minus 2, 4 square, 16, which is 2 pi. right? Yes, coming to the last problem, fifth one. So this is the integration of a to b root of b minus x by 7 minus f x minus a. So which value is pi by 2 of b minus a, which is a 7 minus 3, 4, that is 2 pi. Okay, yes students, next time onwards better to use these shortcuts. Within 1 minute you are going to get the answer. Okay, while practicing these problems number of times, you may get easily and you can save the time. Okay, come on students, make a note. Yes students, coming to the next model problems, integration of the partial fractions, right or not? Integration of partial fractions. Actually, what is that? The traditional method. This fraction, this which is going to divide into the partial fractions, and then after we will get the three fractions, and then after integrating the each and every fraction. Of course, it will take the time to find out the values. So, a by x minus 1 plus b by x plus 2 plus c by x minus 3. By finding the ABC values, so then after we are going to find the integration values. Okay, not? Okay, yes. So, here I am going to use that one shortcut for this one. Let us see. Okay, yes. For this one, so what are the roots for this equation? X is equals to 1, x is equals to minus 2, and x equals to 3. Okay, yes, come on, first substitute x is equals to 1. Substitute x is equals to 1 in this equation, which is 2 ones minus 1 by, in this case, yes, you can substitute only here and in these two. You should not substitute here. Okay, it is 1 plus 2 into 1 minus 3 of logarithm of modulus of x minus 1 plus, now substitute x is equals to minus 2. Now it is 2 times of minus 2 minus 1 by, now x is equals to minus 2, we should not substitute here, we can substitute. So here this is minus 2 minus 1 of minus 2 minus 3 of logarithm of modulus of x plus 2 plus, and the third one, third fraction is substitute x is equals to 3, that is 2 of 3 minus 1 by, so here x is equals to 3, you can substitute in these two, that is 3 minus 1 of 3 plus 2 of logarithm of modulus of x minus 3, that is the problem. Afterwards you can simplify that, the constants, which is 2 1's minus 1, 1 by 3 minus 2, 1 by minus 6 of logarithm of modulus of x minus 1, first term plus the second term, minus 4 minus 1, minus 5, second factor, minus 5 by minus 3, yeah, minus 3 minus 5, which is 50 of logarithm of modulus of x plus 2, and the last term is 6 minus 1, 5 by 10, 5 by 10, 2 by 10, of logarithm of modulus of x minus 3. Okay, yes, in this case we will get that the integration of the partial fractions. Okay students, make a note. Then after, please try this problem, integration of 3x minus 2 by x minus 1 into x plus 2 of x minus 3. Yeah, what are we going to substitute? X equals to 1, x equals to minus 2, and x equals to 3. By taking x is equals to 1, you can substitute here, and you should not substitute here in these two, of logarithm of x minus 1 plus the second fraction, x is equals to minus 2, you can get that. After that, x is equals to 3. Okay, yes, come on, make a note. Yes, this will be the very easy method for integration of the partial fraction method. Okay.